Everything good, everything bright, everything holy, everything right, everything worthy, all that I should. All is well, cause I'm gonna dwell on everything.
When I think of a mother, I have to think of prayer, amen. How many times have I heard the story of someone standing and testifying of their mother's prayers? And that's where it's at, folks, today. That we would be that source, that we would be that one that would lift up the needs before the Lord our God, who is able to meet every need in our lives. Amen. Amen. His blessings will be upon us. His power, His Spirit is what we need in our lives. And I believe that if we're faithful to lift them up, you know, to lift up those prayers before the Lord and to be that person, if there's any person I want to be a mother that prays and seeks the Lord. Amen. And I pray that's your prayer here today. Praise the Lord. If you have your Bibles, I want you to turn to the book of 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy chapter 1. We're going to read. Praise the Lord. I just want to thank all of our mothers and thank each and every one for what you do and for your obedience and your sacrifice. If there's anything, the meaning of a mother is selfless, because when you become a mother, it's no longer about you. It's about your children and your heart and your passion for your family. And that's what it should be. That's what God intended us to be. So I pray that the blessing of the Lord would be upon you and your family today. And I just thank you for your dedication to this church and your dedication. You know, I was thankful that I was able to, you know, any time when you can give the Word of God to someone, and I was just blessed this morning teaching the Word of God to Caden in Sunday school and just receiving those blessings. I'm here to tell you, there are things that no one can steal them away from you. Moth and rust cannot destroy. Invest in those things that will be laid up in heaven, praise God, and will never deteriorate or rot away.
Amen.
Praise God.
Thank you.
2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 5. And it says, when I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and in thy mother Eunice, and I am persuaded that in thee also. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance, that thou stir up the gift of God which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God had not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind.
Amen.
Thank God for His Word. Let's pray. Lord, we're just thankful, Jesus, for this day, and we thank you for your word. We know that heaven and the earth are going to pass away one day, but we're so thankful, Lord, that your word will sustain the test of time. It will be here forever and ever, and we can surely count on the word of the Lord to save us and to lift us up and to give us what we need. We need the word of the Lord in our lives today. I pray, Lord, that they would not hear me, but that they would hear your voice speak to them today. Lord, I bring nothing that is in me, Lord, but Lord, I know, God, that your word, you want your word to continue to go forth in our lives and to bring deliverance, to bring power, and to bring salvation, Lord, to our lives. Yes. We give you thanks, we give you praise, and we ask it in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
amen.
Amen. Can we just lift our hands to the Lord right now, and let's just praise Him with our voices.
Praise
Come on,
Lord,
lift your voice.
Lord,
it says to praise the Lord,
you, Lord,
with your voice, to show Him praise and adoration. And Lord, we want to praise you. We want to open our mouths, because it says in your word, if we we don't praise you that the rocks would cry out. Lord, we want to give you praise because you have given us breath in our bodies, Lord. You have given us life and you have given it to us more abundantly. Lord, we praise you today and we thank you for your many blessings and we thank you for this time that we can hear the word of the Lord go forth. We give you glory, we give you praise. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. This is a letter to Timothy, a promise, if you could, to put it into words. But when I read this scripture, this is where it's at, folks. When I read this scripture, I'm here to tell you, we need to let this gospel go forth to generation, so that it never stops, but that the seed of righteousness and the power of God would be working in our lives nonstop, so that the generations to follow us will receive of the power of the Spirit in our lives.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
I am so blessed as I read this scripture where Paul declares it in this scripture that when he was telling Timothy that it was not only the touch of the Lord upon his life, but it was because of the generations before him that had followed into righteousness and that had followed into the truth. I want to be that generation that will rise up and to declare to a world that maybe is full of darkness, maybe there is sin all around, but I want to be that one that will share forth the word of God to my family, to my children, to anyone that I come in contact with in my family, that I will somehow reach them for the kingdom of God. Just as this scripture says, Paul says, a remembrance of your unfeigned faith. Now, if you don't know what unfeigned, that means to be sincere before the Lord. That you've taken everything out of your life that doesn't mean much, and you say, Lord, I know what you have done for me. I know where you have brought me from. And a lot of times, I think that's where we need to go this morning. We need to remember what God has brought us from. Amen. We need to think where God has taken us and where we could be, but because of Jesus Christ and his love and his power and the Holy Spirit speaking to our lives, we are here in the presence of God and we can receive the blessings that he has for us today.
Amen.
Praise God. I'm so thankful, and I think a lot of times as mothers, you know, I am truly blessed. I am truly blessed really on both sides of my family. And, you know, a lot of people will kind of pinpoint maybe one side. But I am thankful for both sides of my family that, yes, my grandmother on my mother's side, she received the Lord. And I've told it here before, but my dad always said when my grandmother got saved, she got saved. She turned away from her sin and she lived her life wholeheartedly for the Lord. And she was an example to us grandchildren. And she lived her life serving the Lord to her very last breath. Praise God. I am thankful for the generations that have laid the path of righteousness. And it is very important that we see that it's not only the men, but it's also the women that have laid a foundation for us to follow, for us to receive the blessings of the Lord. How many can say, are you thankful for your mothers today?
Amen. Amen. There you go.
I am thankful for my mom today. I am thankful that when my dad started this church, she got on the bandwagon. And I've seen a lot of situations where men have started and had the calling of God on their lives, but the wife wasn't right there doing what they were called to do. But I am thankful for her that she got us ready for church. She got us dressed. She got us on the church van, and we found ourselves in these pews hearing the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And I am thankful for all of you here today that have taken the time. I'm here to tell you all the things that you invest in your children and the material things. And I know there's all kinds of nice things, and I'm not against those things. But I want you to have the right priorities, what is important for your children. And I'm here to give you those things today. What is the most important for your children to receive is the things of God. We come here to receive the things of God. What is it? A measly 2 hours that we can receive of the things of God? Just 2 hours of our time if we would put wholeheartedly into it and we would say, today is the Lord's day. I'm going to get up and I'm going to go to Sunday school. I'm going to teach my children the things of God. I'm going to make sure that they, even though they might not feel like getting up, they're going to get dressed and they're going to find themselves in Sunday school, so that they can hear the word of the Lord, and when they come into the sanctuary, they can receive the blessings of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's what's important in this life. Those are the things that will be treasured. I always say, it seems like so many times when Shannon comes home and tells me testimonies of truck drivers, a lot of times it's not really they bring up their dad a lot of times. A lot of times they bring up their mother or their grandmother, because it was their mother and their grandmother that said, hey, we're going to go to church today. You're going to find yourself in the house of God so that you can receive the spiritual things. And it's the things that count for a lifetime and that go on for eternity that you can never take it away.
That's true.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want those things. And I want to guard, and I want to teach those things. And that's what Paul was trying to share with Timothy. And he was a man of God. He was brought up to preach and to teach. Why? But why was he there? It was because of his grandmother and his mother that laid the foundation for him so that he could be used of the Lord. Hallelujah. It was because of their faith in God. It was because of the foundation that they laid and said, no more of this lifestyle of mediocrity. No more of this lifestyle of just going through the motions. No, I want my children to receive the blessings of the Lord.
Amen.
How many want your children to receive the blessings of the Lord?
Yes.
Our children are our everything. They are our life. They are what we care about. Really, I say sometimes that's why I think I got these gray hairs. Some people say, you know, your children are what give you the gray hairs, or maybe give you the wrinkles because you're always giving instruction. But that's our duty today, that we would not let them go to do what they want to do, but that we would tell them the gospel of Jesus Christ, that we would not back down, but that we would declare it to them that they need the Lord. I want to be that person that plants that seed of righteousness into my family. I want to plant that seed in my son. And I thank God for him. You know, most of you know the story of Matthias and how God blessed me with him. And God just orchestrated the whole thing to where we could adopt Matthias. And I always tell him it wasn't calling a number to you know, some kind of adoption agency. No, all we did was we prayed and we asked God for his will and his way. And I always tell him, I can lay it out to him and show him that it wasn't me that placed him in my arms. It was God that placed him in my arms.
Amen. Thank God.
See, God has a plan for each and every one. And I sometimes think of all the little babies. I think of all the children, you know, that are not blessed to have the good things of life, you know, that don't have a good home, that don't have love, that don't have the love of God and the power of God to show forth in their life. And I always tell, I say it to Matthias, I always tell him it won't be because of me or Shannon, because we have showed him the way to follow. And we didn't just say it with our words, but we lived our lives, and he has seen it down through the years. So if it's his decision that he turns away from God, it won't be because that I never showed him the way, because I'm here to tell you, we need to blast it from the mountaintops, and we need to declare it to those that need Jesus Christ, and especially those in our household. It first dwelt, as it says here, in my grandmother, or it says here in Timothy's grandmother, and then in his mother Eunice. And I was just sharing Sunday night, you know, about this church. And many of you may not know, but my great-grandmother, this was her home place. This is where her house was. In fact, I didn't even know it. The one, two sides of the walls of the house, when they did the siding and had the siding done, I did not know that the house structure was still there. And see, God has a plan, but what I want to try to get your attention to was my great-grandmother, which was my dad's grandmother. She was a woman of God. She was a woman of prayer. Now, I never got to meet her because she passed away before I was born. But I've heard lots of stories, and I know Nancy can share stories of her life. But there's one thing I came across the other, it's been a while back. I came in Denny's, and my grandmother's brother used to attend this church. In fact, Earl made the altar. There's other things that he made, this podium. He got saved, gloriously saved, and God used him in this church and to build this church, praise God, so that we can come in here and we can worship the Lord. But his son, I ran into him not long ago, and he started talking about Grandma Pearl. And talking about how when he would come into the house, she would instruct him and to him about learning the scriptures. And I never knew that. I never knew that she had pushed that onto him and wanted him to learn the scriptures. And she would give him something special if he knew the scriptures. And it's so important that we do these things with our children. Because the word of the Lord, as I said it before, the word of the Lord will do great and mighty things in our lives. It cannot be taken away from us. And I think down through the years, as Grandmother Pearl passed away, then my grandmother, Eva Voorhees, she got saved, and she was faithful to this church as my dad pastored this church for 40-some years and was faithful to the house of the Lord, and she was a faithful Bible reader. And she served the Lord with all of her heart. See, those are examples that we need to follow through with. Amen. We don't need to give up. We don't need to be ashamed of what God has done. As it says in 1 Timothy 4:12, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity.
Yes.
Boy, we've come a long way from that. You know, I was watching one of those old 70s shows, Good Times. But the whole story, plot of the story was the young boy, Michael, got a job. He got a job with a man who did not believe in God. He was an atheist. He did not believe in God, and he was following in the pattern instead of following in the things that he was brought up to believe in God, because his mom declared God in everything. In this plot of the story, she said, "We believe in God. We stand on God and the values of the Almighty." And long to make a long story short, she even went to the place to where she went to the man that he worked for, and she said, I want you to fire him. I don't want him to work here anymore because you are not a good influence on him." See, sometimes we've got to guard our children from the world. We've got to guard our children from the enemy. We've got to know that it is through the power of God and our decisions that we make. And she didn't look at the dime or the dollar to say, "Oh, well, we need the money. We live in the ghetto. We're just going to have to do." And no, it wasn't a matter of that. It was saying, "No, I'm willing to forsake all so that he will believe in God." It was a testimony. It was a little bit of a lesson to the world today that we've got to take a stand for righteousness. It talks about in Psalms 22:30, "A seed shall serve him, and it shall be accounted to the Lord for a generation. They will proclaim his righteousness to a people yet unborn, for he has done it." What's that scripture saying? He's saying he's going to raise up a generation. He's going to raise up a seed that will share the love of Jesus Christ so that other generations can follow through and receive of the power of God. I want this righteousness, this seed, to grow into our lives so that we don't let this thing die down, but we let this thing spring forth in our lives, and we do whatever we can to get our children, to get our family, to get our loved ones into the kingdom of heaven.
Amen. Thank God.
I was thinking the other day, I remember when we had a picture. I wanted to try to find it so you could see it. Back years ago when Jeremy had Isabella, there was a 5 generations. They took a picture. It was my grandmother Eva, it was Dad, Tanya, and Jeremy and Isabella. 5 generations. And if we look at it that way, as we go down the line of our family, the generations, are they going to know the truth of the gospel? Are they going to know what it's like to be found in the house of God? Are they going to know the Bible because they were found in Sunday school hearing the word of the Lord? See, you might not look at it as much, but there are seeds being planted in your children when they hear the word of the Lord. When they hear of a Bible book or a Bible verse, that word gets planted in them, and God can use it at any time in their life. That's why it's so important that we grasp hold of this as the church.
Yes.
Amen. Are you the church? Are you the body of Christ that wants to see this thing go forth? That you want to see the kingdom of heaven? No, we want to see God touch our lives so that we can pass it on down to generation after generation.
Right.
Psalms 48 says, "Mark ye well her bulwarks." That means the walls. "Mark ye well her walls, consider her palaces, that ye may tell it to the generations following." We need to mark our walls. We need to see where we're at this morning, what we need God to do in our lives, where we can grow deeper into the things of God, where we're lacking, and come up to where God wants to take us, and we will be what God has called us to be, a church and a body of Christ that will stand for righteousness.
Amen.
I want to stand for those things. I think of, and I heard Brother Batchelor tell the his sermon, if you could find it somewhere, I don't know if it's available online, but we were at a service where he preached on the widow's oil. You can find it in 2 Kings chapter 4. She was a widow. Her husband was a devout man. He was a man of God. He served the Lord, but here she was. She was a widow. She was without. She didn't have much, but there's one thing she did have. She had two sons. And it said that she was in debt, and the creditors were coming to take her children from her to be bondmen. And it says in that scripture that Elisha came, and she cried out to Elisha, "What can I do?" And it says in that scripture that he said, "What do you have in your house?" She says, "All I've got is just a little pot of oil." He said, bring it, we're going to use it. But he goes, "I want you to go out, and I want you to go gather up all the vessels that you can find from your neighbors, borrowing them from your neighbors, and don't just get a little, get a lot." See, that's how we need to be in an expectation for our family and for our children. We need to be thinking that God is wanting to give us much, amen? He's wanting to bless us. He doesn't want to hold back, but He wants to give us and pour out blessings upon our lives. Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah.
And it says she did. She was obedient. She went out and she got all of the oil pots that she could find. And she didn't get a little. She got as many as she could. But she took the pot that she'd already had, because he says that's the one you're going to use. See, that's the representation of the seed that God has in each and every one of us. He has that in you, that he'll use the small and he'll make big out of it.
Thank God. Amen.
And that's, as it says in the scripture, the laying on of hands, stir up that gift that is within you. See, you've got the gift. You've got the blessing of the Lord. Now you've got to put it to use. And so he told her, he goes, "Once you get all those pots, I want you to go into your house. And I want you to take your sons with you." It didn't say leave the sons outside. No, he said take your sons with you and go in and pour out the oil into the vessels. And so she did. And she shut the door. And it says she began to pour that oil into the vessels. And I liked how Brother Batchelor put it into an explanation. He said he didn't go in and Elisha didn't pour the oil. No, he told her to pour in the oil. And that is a representation that we need to pour the oil of love and joy and salvation into our children, into our families. We need to give all. And it says that she told her son to bring another pot. And he says, "There are no more. You filled them all up." And God had blessed her. And it said she took that oil and she sold it, and she was able to pay the creditors.
Amen.
See, I'm here to tell you that's what God wants to do for each and every one of you today. He wants to pour out the oil of blessing. And He don't want it just to be for you, but He wants it to be for your household today. He wants that blessing to be upon us. I was reading in Romans 9:29 where it says, and as Isaiah said before, "Except the Lord Almighty had left us a seed, we would have become like Sodom and we would have been like Gomorrah." It's because of that seed of righteousness that is still going forth. And I know there are evil men that are trying to stamp it out of this nation. But I believe that God is going to raise up a generation that He can use. And that's why it's so important that we are here to receive of that, so that it can go from Spirit will go forth, and that gift that is within us will go forth to not only past generations, but it will go to future generations. Can you say amen? Let's stand.
Everything good, everything bright, everything holy, everything right, everything worthy, all that I should.